Hello everyone. Today we are going to talk about the part 2 which covers the content about the education regulations 2020 which are officially published in the Gazette of India, the Pharmacy Council of India notification New Delhi on 9th of October 2020 for the diploma course in pharmacy. According to the notification, we are going to cover in the second video about the chapter 2, that is course structure and examination. So according to the education regulations 2020 for diploma course in pharmacy, which are published in the Gazette of India Extraordinary, the chapter 2 is about course structure and the exams which are going to be conducted. So to start with the first part, that is diploma in pharmacy, about part 1 and part 2, that is first year and second year. The minimum qualification required to get entry into diploma in pharmacy course is the candidate must have passed in 10 plus 12 examination and from the science academic stream. Arts and commerce stream students are not allowed. Science academic stream, that too with the subjects physics, chemistry and biology or mathematics, or any other qualification which is approved by the Pharmacy Council of India as the equivalent to this above examination, that is HSC examination, higher secondary exams. Next point talks about the duration of the course. After the eligibility, the duration means, one, the candidate enters into the diploma course in pharmacy through the admission procedure and the norms laid down by DTE, Director of Technical Education. The course duration is for 2 academic years, and the each academic years out of the 2 academic years shall spread over a period of not less than 180 working days. In addition, there shall be 500 hours of practical training spread over a period of not less than 3 months. That means after completion of first year and second year, there will be a, as in a common internship, which is of 500 hours of practical training, the course of study. The course of study talks about, and it gives the information, subject as given in the table, the number of hours devoted to each subject for teaching in theory and practical shall not be less than the noted in table. That means the table which is given over here, the table 1, which is for the part 1, that is first year diploma in pharmacy, according to the education regulations 2020, the subjects for part 1 are enlisted here. The first subject is pharmaceutics, second is pharmaceutical chemistry, then pharmacognosy, then human anatomy and physiology, and last one is social pharmacy for part 1. And the number of hours prescribed are shown over here separately for theory and practical along with tutorial hours. So pharmaceutics theory hours 75, pharmaceutical chemistry 75, cognosy theory hours 75, then HAP theory hours 75, social pharmacy theory hours 75. So all the subjects have the common theory as well as common practical hours of 75 hours. That means weekly it will be divided into 3 sessions of each, and theory total comprise 375 hours. Then practical total comprise 375 hours, and tutorial each subject is having of that of 25 hours, which totally comprise 125 hours. So according to the rule, the number of hours devoted to each subject for its teaching in theory as well as practical shall not be less than the mentioned in the table. So whatever are the numbers mentioned over here, the actual practice should also contain the same number, not less than this. However, the course of the study and practical training may be modified by the Transparency Council of India from time to time. That means the PCI keeps the right to modify the content about the course of study and practical training. Again, same table 2 includes part 2, that is for second year diploma in pharmacy. The subjects according to the Education Regulation 2020, subjects are enlisted here. Total 6 subjects are there. In part 1, there were 5 subjects. The names of the subjects goes like this. First, pharmacology. Then second, community pharmacy and management. Third is biochemistry and clinical pathology. Fourth is pharmacotherapeutics. Fifth is hospital and clinical pharmacy. And sixth is pharmacy law and ethics. So, these subjects, they have again theory. If you will see, the common hours distribution is there. The number of hours are distributed. Like for all subjects, all 6 subjects, it is 75 hours. So, 75 multiplied by 6, it is 450. So, total number of theory hours are 450 hours. Then for practical, you can see, in as in case part 1, part 1 were having practicals for all the subjects. In second year, there is a difference. Last subject, which is pharmacy law and ethics, do not contain any practical session. Practical hours are not there. And pharmacology practical hours designated are 50. Community pharmacy and management are 75. Biochemistry and clinical pathology, again 50 hours. And pharmacotherapeutics and HCP practical hours are 25-25 each. So, these total hours comprise 225 hours, these 450 hours of theory, 225 hours of practical. And again, for tutorials, if you will see, the same as that of part 1, 25 hours for each subject, and 25 multiplied by 6, again it is 150. So, 450 for theory, 225 for practical, 150 for tutorial. So, according to the rule, they should not be less than the noted in table. That means the number of hours, one should complete these many number of hours when it comes to the conduction of theory as well as practicals. Table 3 shows the detailed activities regarding the practical training. That means after completion of part 1 and part 2, that is first year and second year, we are supposed to focus on the part 3, that is practical training, which is of 500 hours, approximately 3 months. It should not be less than 3 months. The activities one should go under the practical training hours. The activities includes stocking of drugs and medical devices if are in your whatever the pharmacist is practicing. The registered pharmacist should be there. Then the practicing pharmacist, like who is taking the training, should be there. So all the details are again in briefly they have mentioned in chapter 3, where we are going to focus about the criterias, how many numbers of pharmacists and trainees should be there and what are the work responsibilities. Then second, inventory control procedures. Then handling of prescriptions, dispensing, and then patient counseling. These all activities are involved or one is supposed to undergo during the practical training of 500 hours. Coming towards the next point, that is examination. Whereas the examinations are concerned, there shall be an annual examination at the end of the academic year. Now, since this is the annual pattern, there will be one annual exam at the end of the academic year. That means part 1, at the end there will be one annual exam. Part 2, at the end there will be one annual exam. If necessary, there shall be a supplementary examination of for the students who are not able to pass diploma in pharmacy part 1 or part 2. It is if necessary, the student can undergo this supplementary examination. Then the examination shall be of written and practical form. That is, practical includes viva voce. Nature carrying maximum marks for each part of the subject as indicated in table 4 and 5. The nature of the exam and marks criteria, all is given in table 4 and table 5. So now we'll discuss in detail what is the information given in table 4 and table 5. So as far as the table 4 is concerned, it is for the part 1 of diploma in pharmacy, and table 5 is for the part 2 for diploma in pharmacy, that is first year DPharm and second year DPharm examination. Now, whereas the part 1 exam is concerned, the subjects we have already seen, pharmaceutics, chemistry, cognosy, HAP and social pharmacy, these are the 5 subjects according to the educational regulations 2020, and these 5 subjects have the maximum marks distribution for theory as well as practicals. So just now we seen that at there shall be an annual exam at the end of the each academic year. So the annual examination is of 80 marks, all subjects 80 marks for theory as well as for practicals, all subjects 80 marks. And the sessionals, that is the internal examinations which are conducted, that are of 20 marks for both theory as well as practicals. The further distribution will we see in next point, coming points. And 80 plus 20, that is final exam, that is annual exam, and sessional exam, that is internal exam, total comprise 100. So 5 subjects, then 100 multiplied by 5, total will be 500 for theory, same for practicals, all 5 subjects they have practicals, each comprising 80 plus 80 20 distribution. So 5 practicals, so 100 into 5, again it is 500. So total marks comes to 1000, 500 for theory, 500 for practicals, and from 1000 you have the minimum passing criteria. Again, for part 2 diploma in pharmacy exam, the educational regulation 2020 describes these 6 subjects for second year diploma in pharmacy. The subjects, again they have the same marks distribution. You can see maximum marks for theory, maximum marks for practical, 80 80 80 each subject for theory, 20 20 20 for each subject in theory. Then since there are 6 subjects, so 100 into 6, it comes to 600. But when it comes to practicals, one subject is not having the practical, that means 5 they are having practical, and the same distribution final, that is annual practical examination, will be of 80 marks, and internal exam, that is sessional exam, will be of 20 marks for each subject. So these are the 5 subjects for which practicals are there. So these 5 subjects, also 100 multiplied by 5, again this 400 plus 100 will give you 500. So 600 plus 500 will total comes to 1100. So first year, that is part 1 examination, marks are from out of 1000, and for part 2 exams they are out of 1100. Now next is eligibility for appearing at the diploma in pharmacy part 1 and part 2 exam. What is the criteria so that one can appear for the annual exam which is there in part 1 and part 2? So only such candidates who produce the certificate from the head of the academic institution are eligible for part 1 and part 2 examination. So what is the criteria for this certificate which is given by the head of the academic institution so that the candidate can appear for the annual exam? The criteria says the attendance should be 75%. 75% of the attendance in both theory and in practical separately. That means if you will see the distribution in the table, pharmacology, theory, whatever number of lectures are being conducted, minimum 75% of the lectures should be attended of that of theory, and same for the practical. So the distribution is individual for theory and practical. That means 75% attendance in theory and 75% attendance in practical. That too in each subject is mandatory. That means according to the that from the subject to subject it is mandatory. It's not that the average is taken. If you have 6 subjects in your part 2 examination, 5 subjects in your part 1 examination, so each individual subject should have 75% attendance in respective section, that is theory as well as practicals. Next criteria for the mode of examination. The mode of examination, that means theory as well as practical exams, how they are conducted. So the mode of examination, again it is included in table 4 and table 5 and shall be of 3 hours duration, both theory as well as practicals. That means theory marks, that is for 80 marks the paper is there, and practical also for 80 marks the exam is there. So both theory as well as practicals should have the minimum time duration of 3 hours as 2 separate papers. Both theory and practicals are considered 2 separate papers. A candidate failing shall reappear for the failed subject. That means if the candidate fails in part 1 or part 2 examination, that can reappear for the failed subject. Again, it is individual for theory and practical. Theory and practical of particular subjects are considered as individual subject. That means candidate failing in theory supposed to reappear for the theory. Candidate failing in theory practical again is supposed to reappear for theory as well as practical. Then next is award of sessional marks and maintenance of records. So, sessional marks, as we have seen, according to the table, the sessional marks, that is internal marks conducted, are of 20 marks for each theory and practical. So, 20 marks for theory, 20 marks for practical. And how is the division? There shall be 2 or more periodic sessional. That means, generally the pattern which was previously followed according to the Educational Regulations 1991 was 3 maximum sessionals or periodic exams, internal assessment. Then out of that, the average of 2 performances shall be considered as the basic criteria for calculating the sessional marks. That is 2 or more periodic sessional examination during each academic year. For part 1, the average of best 2 is considered. For part 2, the average of best 2 is considered. See, the highest aggregate of any 2 performances shall form the basis for calculating the sessional marks in both theory as well as practicals. The sessional marks in practicals shall be allotted on the following basis. That means actual performance, actual preparation or any actual chemical reaction or any actual performing part, whereas the subject concerned, according to the subject, this actual performance heading will vary. So that actual performance is of 10 marks and day-to-day assessment. The day-to-day assessment which is done in the practical class, that is daily, day-to-day, as the name suggests, day-to-day, that means according to the hours distribution, if the practical hours are 75, then 3 hours per week the practical will be there. So, according to the weeks, the weekly attendance, that is in each practical, the attendance will be monitored, and it will be monitored under subheadings such as the experimental part, then GLP part the person is following, then synopsis, viva, manual marks, all these criteria, sub criteria are there in day to day assessment, which includes 10 marks. So this 10 plus 10 will get 20. So practical is of 20, then theory is of 20, and average of best 2 is considered. Then minimum marks for passing the examination shall be at least 40% in each subject separately. That means whereas the individual subject is concerned, minimum 40% passing criteria is there. That means out of total marks 100, there is minimum 40 marks. So this is the passing criteria for all the exam, all the subjects, theory as well as practical. And the candidate scoring marks above 60% can be graded into first class, and the 75% marks or the above in any subject can be graded under the distinction class. But the grant of these first class and distinction shall be subjected to the condition that the candidate shall pass in a single attempt. So the single attempt, if the candidate is passing, then this criteria will be held applicable. Then next point includes eligibility for promotion to diploma in pharmacy part 2. If the candidate who is appearing for the part 1 examination and passes that exam will only be promoted to part 2 class, but part 2 class promotion includes one important clause, that is failure in more than 2 subjects is not allowed, or that candidate who is failing more than 2 subjects cannot be allowed or is not eligible for the part 2 class, means cannot be admitted or promoted to part 2 class. So maximum 2 subjects are allowed for to keep the term, and more than that the candidate will not be promoted to part 2 class. Next is improvement of sessional marks. Now there is a provision for improvement of sessional marks if the candidate feels, or the institute feels, about the sessional marks average which was there previously is not satisfactory, or the candidate wants to improve their sessional marks. They can do so by appearing in the 2 additional exams which are known by the name improvement exam, which are there for both theory as well as practical. But there is one criteria: the day-to-day marks which are awarded in the practical class cannot be improved unless that candidate undergoes regular course of the study again. So day-to-day marks cannot be changed, or day-to-day marks cannot be improved, rather you can say. Then approval of the examinations. Now examining authority concerned fulfills the conditions specified in appendix B to these regulations. Now approval of the examinations. Now all these regulations whatever are mentioned, according to the Pharmacy Council India under the subsection 2 of section 12 of the Pharmacy Act 1948, such approval shall be granted only if the examining authority, that means exam taking authority concerned, fulfills the conditions given in the appendix B. Now this appendix B is included in chapter 4. We'll have just a review of appendix 4, what it says. Now see, this is the appendix B. What are the conditions to be fulfilled by the examining authority? So according to the PCI, the examining authority can be a statutory Indian university or the body, the say for example Mumbai University, or the board which is conducting the exam, and it shall ensure the discipline and decorum of the examination. That means this body will be held responsible for the discipline and decorum of the examination, and this body should provide, or the exam centers can be deputed with the adequate rooms with necessary furniture for holding written examination, well-equipped laboratories for holding practical examination. Along with this infra, there should be adequate number of qualified and responsible examiners and staff, other staff, accessory staffs required to conduct and invigilate the examination. All these facilities are necessary for efficient and proper conduct of the exam. So this appendix B, these are the regulations which are to be followed or which are to be satisfied by the examining authority. And if this statement of marks secured by the candidate in the exam after payment of prescribed fee, the examining authority is eligible, or examining authority will make the candidate eligible only to attempt the exam after the payment of the prescribed fees by the examining authority, and the examiners appointed should have the qualification. They should be teachers, or either they should have the equivalent qualification to those of the teachers in respect to the subjects which are shown in appendix A. That means whatever are the subjects, they should have the equivalent qualification of that of teachers. Then all these two, the main important point is the chairperson of examining committee or at least one expert member should have the pharmacy qualification. They only are appointed as examining authority chairperson or at least expert member. They should have the pharmacy qualifications. With this, we finish with the chapter 2 and stay tuned for the next chapter 3 practical training, which we are going to cover in next video. Thank you.